All right, so let's talk about your challenge for today. So here we are with the application, and this is the application stack for Pocambo, the one we have taken for the project. And the user interacts with the front end. The front end is a Node.js application. And then you have a couple of applications right here. There is a cards application. I think this cards application is a Java application. Uses Maven as the build tool, and the catalog is a Golang application. So there are three different applications with three different technologies, and each of this connects to a database. So the cards has a DB, the cards DB, the Golang has a DB connects to one of this is a NoSQL, one of this is a SQL DB, a relational database. Now, what is your task? Your task is to start setting up a continuous integration workflow for these two applications. One Node application, second is the Java application. What is the purpose? Purpose is simple. Basically, whenever a developer checks in the code for the Node application or writes a code and pushes it to the common Git repository, your job is to set up an automated pipeline so that a sequence of jobs are run to test that code. What are the things that you typically test? Whether the application builds fine or not. That's one. Second is you may want to run some unit tests. You may want to run code coverage tests. You may want to run static code analysis. So we are going to keep the pipelines very simple for now, for today's project, right? For your today's challenge. So you are going to set up, so anytime there is a check-in on this Node application, you want to trigger a bunch sequence of jobs. What is that sequence? There will be three jobs, and this happens on Jenkins actually. Consider this as a Jenkins server, and then you run three different jobs. One, to build this application. Second is to run some unit tests. Third is you want to, after the testing is done, you also want to create an artifact that you can distribute, and you can use that artifact to install that application on certain environments, right? So that is what happens in the package job here. Now, the steps depend on the application typically. This is something you should learn a little bit on. As a DevOps professional, DevOps engineer, you don't have to write the code, but these are the things that you should know about. How do you build a Node.js application? How do you test it? How do you package it? How do you do that for the Java application, for the Golang application? Now, I'll just brief you about the steps. For the build job, you have a step called as npm install. Typically, a Node.js application uses npm as a node package manager, and this actually helps you to build, to test, to create a package out of your application, or run some random random tasks that you want to do on this application. And it uses or reads typically it reads a file called as package.json. That is where all the build instructions are. Just like if you use a Maven application, there is pom.xml file. You have a package.json for a Node application. So this is something you should go and read carefully. This is something you should know about very well. And then you run this sequence of steps. And basically, anytime there is a check-in, you should run these tasks. And then this gives the feedback to the developer. So if the build fails, there could be a dependency problem with a Node.js application. Node.js application doesn't compile. You don't have to compile it, just like Python, Shell. So Java application, C application, Go application, you have to compile. There are compilers for it. There are two types of application. One is compiled, one is interpreted. Compiled application needs a compiler, and you convert it into a binary artifact here. Versus an interpreted application is a code that you deploy directly. A Node application, there'll be a Node.js file, .js files. There'll be Python.py files, which you can run directly, and those are run at the runtime. They are interpreted basically, right? So Node.js, even though it is interpreted application, what you do with build is just to check whether your dependency management or anything else, there is a problem with dependency, version of the Node.js, and that's what you test here. That's build. The second is the npm test. So this is where you run npm install followed by, let's say, npm test. There is no npm package directly, but you can write some custom scripts in package.json. And from there, you can use, in our example, these scripts already exist. So just have a look at that. So npm run, not rum, npm run package. This is what you have to do. And this is for the Node.js application. Similarly, you will create build, test, and package jobs for the Maven, the Java application. In case of Java application, the build, same job names, but with different steps. So for build, you're going to have, this is Maven. It's going to read pom.xml just like package.json. And here you run slightly different commands. Maven compile. For test, it is mvn test. And for packaging, mvn package. There are some options that you can also add. Let's say if you have already tested, you don't want to run the test again, because if you run Maven package, it also runs the test and compiles also. So you don't want to do that. So you can add some options like skip tests. And once you create these jobs, you have to also connect them and create a pipeline out of it using the pipeline view, the build pipeline plugin, that is, right? So this is your challenge for today. You have to create two pipelines, one for the Node.js application front end, second for the cards application here, right? And you have to also connect those jobs together. So you have to define the upstream. This is the downstream, this is the upstream. This is the downstream, this is the upstream. You have to define those upstream downstream links, which I have already taught you. If you have gone through the Jenkins essential lessons, you should have already known about that, as well as the build plugin, right? So simple jobs, simple pipelines is what you have to create. And what I would recommend is you go through this task on your own, go through the challenge, try to do it yourself. And if you cannot do it, or if you struggle, if you have any issues, you can always go and check out the lessons, the solutions, where I actually describe and show you how to get this done. Right, that's your challenge for the day. And see if you can do it first, and then follow up with the solution. Once you're done, you can also collaborate with the solution and compare it with the approach as well, right? That's what I would recommend. So get started, folks. So that's your challenge for the day. And I'll leave you with that. And I'll come back to you with the solution. All right, all the best.